This story takes place in the distant future, when mutants and demons slither through a world of darkness.
This video originally started off as an idea I had for fans of the Castlevania animated series on Netflix. This would allow them to have something they could possibly dig into while they wait for the next Castlevania Nocturne to go live, hopefully next year. The perfect anime I would compare Castlevania to, other than its obvious references to things like Berserk, I would point out one anime I don't hear enough about in the list of references I feel was probably the biggest inspiration for the series, other than Castlevania itself. That series is Vampire Hunter D. Vampire Hunter D started as a series of light novels and audio dramas with Razor of Gales, with four additional releases between 1984 and 1990. The current book count of the series is a surprise to me, but for Vampire Hunter D, we're at volume 30, Gold Fiend, which is slated to release in December next year. There's a ton of lore here, and should the interest be there, I would love to chat about these novels as well as the manga. Basically anything Vampire Hunter D. However, for the sake of this video, I want to talk about the two animated films, Vampire Hunter D and Vampire Hunter D Bloodlust. The first animated film from 1985, Vampire Hunter D, 1 year before I was born, was something I must have watched dozens of times. Rented from my local Blockbuster, which had a surprisingly robust selection of anime titles, this movie fired on another level. And there is a reason it is one of the biggest cult classics in North America. For those new to the series, D is a half-blood Damphir, which was mistranslated, so as a child, I called him a Dunpeel, but there are also some implications. He could be an ancestor to Dracula. D himself essentially picks up and becomes a vampire hunter, and we follow his exploits throughout the series, throughout the books, and the various other adaptations. But I digress. These half-breeds are ideal hunters, and D is arguably the best. Vampire Hunter D is set in 12,090 AD in a post-nuclear, post-apocalyptic world which has been dominated by all species of supernatural entities, from vampires to demons and mutants, and a war between the factions takes place on the planet. The movie itself is slow and dark and perfectly illustrates the things most people come to now expect from films like this within the genre, and if you haven't watched it, I highly recommend you check it out. The second film, Bloodlust, we continued D's journey, and at the time, to me, this was one of the craziest animes I had ever seen in terms of visuals. The animation techniques used in this film at the time were essentially unparalleled. The movie itself is based on the third book of the D novels, Demon Death Chase, and the movie is brutal, bloody, and has a lot in common with darker animes, such as Ninja Scroll, with big bombastic art designs, brutal combat, terrifying enemies, and it's fantastic. And if you're fans of the Castlevania series, this should sound very familiar to you. The story is also much more complex. I feel as we have more parties involved, other hunter groups, crusader types, wizards, and the like. This particular movie also shares a similar storied thread to that of Castlevania, and portrays a fairly sympathetic story to the vampire antagonist in the film, known as Baron Meyer Link. I really don't want to spoil much here, but if you're a fan of Castlevania, I feel these are no-brainers to check out, as The Bones of Castlevania on Netflix, at least in my opinion, live in these two films. Studio Powerhouse have done something amazing with the series and have reinvigorated my love for the genre. And although they wear influences like Avatar: The Last Airbender or Berserk on their sleeve, I would argue that it wouldn't have been possible without a series like Vampire Hunter D paving the way. Also, in case you missed in the intro, this series is still going strong. With new content in the works, the next novel on its way. I think I was only on 7, so I definitely have some catching up to do if they have 30 of them out now. There was also a Kickstarter for a new graphic novel, which was funded insanely fast, which I missed the window for, but I'll need to see if I can get my hand on the 5 issues released with that. However, the big piece of excitement here for me is, hopefully with the pandemic over, the show should be getting back on track. This was announced quite a few years ago, and it was put on hold in 2020. Hopefully we hear some news soon, as I believe the pilot was finished. Either way, if you want to hear more, dig in the spoilers, or chat about Vampire Hunter D books, let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know how you felt about the film as a kid, or if you watched it simply because of this video. That would be awesome, and I would love to hear your thoughts. My name's David. Thanks for watching Storybound. And as always, have a good one.